Please continue, ma'am. I will just do it.
Yeah, in God we trust, all others must bring the data. That is what Deming has told us, right? Actually, the Deming is also a great quality guru in our management philosophy. Deming has told that how we are all believe in God, all the business organizations, they are believing in the data. So you have to bring the data, then only we can find out what is it, what it is inferring from the large amount of data. So the data is a hidden treasure, is there. All the business organizations, especially top executives, can take the right insights about what they have to do, right? The statistics is the key to discover it. As our director madam has already told, that the statistics, and it is a data driven science, is business analytics. So with the data is having a lot of treasure is there. You can apply the simple statistical tools to advance the statistical tools through business analytics. So this is what we are having. So the statistics, I think you all know, I think you might have studied about the little bit of statistics, right? Even though you are PG students or UG students, you know about the statistics. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. What do you mean by statistics? Anybody? Is it a part of mathematics only? Are you applying any quantitative techniques? Have you applied any quantitative techniques? T-test, J-test, have you used mean, median, mode, all those things? Have you used in our statistics?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, we have used.
You have used quantitative, not analytics, yes. Statistics, whatever you are making that inferences, statistical inferences using sample testing, all will come. Usually the statistics is also one of the important part, is it? Actually, the statistics is a part of mathematics. It is divided into three parts: collection of the data, analysis, and then we are inferring or interpreting the results. Analysis is the main thing in the statistics. What test I should use? Whether I should use a inferential statistical tools, whether I should use a descriptive statistical tools, what is it I should use? So you are making analysis. So this is analysis we are doing till now with the past data. Now we are studying analytics. So there is a difference, is there, between analysis and analytics. Analytics is what the trend is today. The analytics is means find out the unknown variable. Some hidden variable is there. Business analytics, I am going to explain some tools. If you use that in our business organization, it is going to tell you that these are all there. You have to do it if you want to be successful in the business organization. So whatever is there, we are doing analysis. We are taking the past data, historical data, through questionnaire we are collecting the primary data, or we are taking secondary data, and we are applying all the statistical tests, and we are making the analysis. Analysis is the past data. But what is happening in today, that is all the data are adding up. Social media data is adding up, then competitor data is adding up, our intermediaries, channels, these people, suppliers are also adding the data. So if you take all this data, you can come into insights. This is called as a big data. Not only internal data, external data also you should take. Analytics will tell you something more is there. If you do that, you will be successful in the organization. Don't worry, when we are going to the other slides, we'll discuss that. Madam, next slide.
1 second, ma'am.
Yeah, so this is what the data is. You all know that in social media, are we not generating so much of data? Just see here, this is 2014 data, I'm able to get it. Just see here, what happens in 1 minute, that is in 160 seconds, in 1 minute, see how many social data is getting generated. Do you know that recently I found out that because of this COVID pandemic situation, in 1 minute, the Google is going through 124,000 searches it is going out. So we have search engine optimization is there. This many searches are going out around the world. You all know that we are in a COVID situation. We are all staying at home. So we are using the internet like anything, like starting from playing the games, listening to the music, watching the movies through Netflix, whatever may be, we are using the internet like anything, right? So the internet usage increase is also very high compare it to the previous years, this is because of this COVID situation. We should not have human contact. We should have through online only. So the usage of social media has gone up. So this is what is called 2014 data itself. If you see through Google, through tweets, through blogs, through Facebook, through Instagram, these so many photos are updated. That is, I am telling about some millions. You can see the numbers in millions. This is 2014 data. If you take the 2020 data as of now, all the numbers is doubling number. So when we are generating this much data, can we take this data and can we bring some insights to your organization? Why these data are going everything waste? If you take the social media data, just post any new product or post your product, say, tell that how you like that product, whether you like or not. Bahubali, before we are going to any movie, Bahubali, you know that how it was successful, right? Whenever if you are going to new movie, you will see that what the other people views are, what are the ratings and what are the views are there, you will see it. If it is a 4 or 5, definitely we'll go and watch the movie. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. If you want to order any books or anything like that, any things through Amazon or Flipkart, then also you see that how many have purchased it, what are their satisfaction level, your ratings we are seeing, their stars we are seeing. Am I right?
Yes.
So if you are able to take the customer feedback, if a simple cinema going itself, we are asking our friends and we are seeing and making a decision before going to cinema and all. If we are a top executives in any business organization, see, if you post your product into any online or into a social media and see that how the customer feels about our product, whether they are happy, whether thumbs up or thumbs down or neutral like that, what they feel, you can take the data and you can analyze and you can come to a situation, right? This many data we are generating. With this data, definitely we can able to obtain the insights. We could able to obtain what we can do for our organization to improve, how we can improve the sales. These are all the things we can see. So this is what is happening here, right? So by 2020, they are telling that the whatever the data we are generating, it will go up to 40 zettabytes. You know what is a byte and zettabyte? Zettabyte is a very big number. We all know about, when I am studying gigabytes and megabytes, not more than that. Terabytes, gigabytes, megabytes. This is what I have studied in DSS like that when we are having that subject. But now we are going to the very high number. That is, the storage space is very high. That is zettabytes and ettabytes. Please go to the next slide, ma'am. Just see here. Universe processable data, that is the whole universe, the data, if you go to see at the end of the 2020, I think because of this COVID situation, it will be more than 40 zettabytes. We are generating, we are messaging to our friends. I cannot meet my friend physically, so daily 10, 15, 20 messages I will be sending to my friend. So you all know it will be more than 40 zettabytes. One byte means how much? 8 bits is one byte, right? 8 bits means, you all know, it will be stored in the form of 0 or 1 character. So 40 zettabytes means 40 into 10 to the power of 21. Just see this table. This is for your understanding. I have studied till gigabytes. Now the information storage is very high. Zettabytes, see the last but one. Zettabytes means 1000 exabytes. If you multiply 10 cube into 10 cube into 10 cube, if you want to convert me into bytes, that will become 10 to the power of 21 bytes. So it is having as much as information as there are grains of the sand on all the world beaches. And all the world beaches, if you take the grains, very difficult to measure the quantity of it. That much information we are having, that much data is there in that, what we call as social media data. So we are reaching ettabytes in near future. In 2030, after 10 years, we are reaching this. So if we are generating this, can the business organization take this data, can do some wonders? Yes, definitely. That is why we are into the business analytics. Just we go and see the next slide. Just here, this is the big data, and this is we are having a very little information previously. Before 5-6 years, we are doing only business analysis. We are taking the questionnaire: what is my problem, research problem? So what are the variables related to it, right? And what is the information I should get my from respondents, people? Collect the data, apply the statistical techniques, make an analysis. What is the appropriate? Do the regression analysis, factor analysis, whatever. Do it. But today it is not like that. Today we are having a big data. Big data means not only internal data or simple data, past data from the customers. We are having a so much of data. Large quantity of data is available in the form of social media. So you can make use of that. External data, that is what is called as external data, operational data, day to day, how the transactions are happening, how I'm giving my services to the people, what the supplier is feeling, how the customers are feeling, operational transactional data, all these other data also we can combine. We can combine all the data and we can make an analytics, and we can see that what the customer still wants, why he is always buying the competitor product, why not me. So if you have that type of questions, you have definitely answers through this BA tools. Yeah, this is called as a big data is very big. We are very small. So how to condense this? We are fighting with a big man, you can see that is big data, right? We can condense that data and we can arrive at the good decisions, right decisions at the right time for the right people, called as a managers. Just see here how data is used for business analytics. If you have data in day-to-day business operations also, we are using for annual reports. Yeah, we are using for annual reports, and we are using for other things like performance analysis, how the operational performance is there, how else we can improve our supply chain quantitative metrics. You can use your whatever the data in arriving at financial statement analysis, financial reporting. We are using the data like that. Now we can use some more thing more than this. Just see here, you are using the data in the business like this. You are using the annual reports, you are using accounting audits, data, we are using all the data. We are using for market research, operational management, performance, economic trends, everywhere we are using the data. Next slide. So every time we are talking about the data and information, right? Have you ever heard of data and information, students? Data and yeah. Is there any difference? Is there in data and information? Sometimes I'm telling as a data, and sometimes I'm telling information. Difference is there, right?
Yes, ma'am. Which we are storing into the system is the data. Which we are getting the data is an information, I think.
Very good. Whatever we get. Yes. What first will come, whether data or information?
Information, I think. Input is first, ma'am. Data is first thing.
Yes. Information. So, but the system will take, if you are doing any projects in MBA projects or anybody doing the projects, SPSS, you will use the data, right? You will have to use only the numbers, right? You will be using only the numbers, right? So the data means just numbers. All our quantitative subjects, statistics, our operations research, everything is playing with the data. But if I tell that 1, 2, just see your example, 50, 500, Kharagpur, it makes any sense? It doesn't make any sense. Unless it is having some units, I can come to a correct thing what I have collected. Just see here, this is called as a data versus information. If I tell that 18, 22, 25, 26, is it making any sense for you students? If I tell the numbers, data, one is 18, 22, 23, yeah. 30, 40. Is it data or information? Students, are you listening to me?
Yes,
data. Data. Data means 18, 20, just quantitative metrics, quantitative numbers is there, that is called as data. So if you don't attach any units to it, if I tell that 18 means years, 22, 24, 30, 35, 40, these are the years, is it making some sense to you? Yes or no? Yes. Information means you are getting what it is. If I tell 100, 200, 300, if I tell it is a rupees, then it is having some sense. If I tell only 100, 200, 300, it doesn't make sense. So for us to understand, information is necessary. Are you getting my point? For us to understand, information is what is necessary. But for software, any software, statistical languages, R language, or if you use for any Minitab like that, statistical software packages, anything like that, these are all, they'll rely on only the data. You have to make the inferences. So just see the next slide, wherein you have a difference between data versus information. Data is on relying on raw facts. It has no context will be there. It can be a text or numbers. Whereas information means it has with context. That is, units will be there. If I tell it as a 100 centimeter, it is emphasizing on length. If I tell it as a 100 kg, then it is emphasizing on weight. So information means processed data, right? So it is a value added to the data. What it is measuring, you will know it. Finally, it will helpful for us to arrive at the decisions. That is what it will do. Whenever the business analytics is there, what the definition I will tell is that to my students, 2D conversion is taking place. Business analytics is a data-driven science wherein it converts 2D. D is converted into one more D. Data is getting converted into the decision-making for the right persons. Who are the right persons here? Our managers at the right time. So 2D conversion is taking place. Data is getting converted into decision-making. Next slide, please. Oh, this is what is happening. We have data, information, knowledge. One more is called as the wisdom is there. You all know wisdom is the most high-level thing, right? That is, the wisdom is the final one. How the data is there, whatever you are getting, the raw facts, observation, all the historical data. Students, historical data means past data. Whatever the past data, you can take it. All this data will come under the data. So all the numbers, quantitative metrics, all will come under data. We have to process it to see that it is having a relevance and purpose. How we have to process it? We have certain tools are there with which we can process. Especially here, I'm going to tell you within 2 minutes what is ETL tools are there, right? ETL tools will process it and it will help the managers for getting the right knowledge. Are you seeing the knowledge? The third stage, it will help in getting the right knowledge. That means it will help the manager in taking the right decisions. So what is wisdom? Whether I should do it or not. Wisdom means high level of knowledge. Whether whatever the path I am going, is it correct or not? After getting the decision making, then you have to be very wise in taking the decision. Whether I should open one more branch of this. Wisdom means whether I should open one more branch of it. One more branch office I should open or not. Whether I can go with one more new product in my R&D department, whether it is feasible. All this type of decision, it is called as a wise decision. So knowledge is telling you whether you should do or you should not do, right? So data is getting converted into information. Processed data is called as information. And it is giving you the knowledge for the decision making. And finally, that is leading to the wisdom. In the next slide, you are going to see why the data is very important. The data is very important because of all this. I already told you, data is very important because of the customer. Customer is king today. Already our Mahatma Gandhi, father of our nation, told us customer is the king. Customer satisfaction, customer delight. Don't go for profits. That is the old management theory says like that. don't ever run for profits. If you aim for customer satisfaction, if you aim for customer delight, remaining things will automatically come to you. Always take the feedback from the customer. See that what else he wants before the competitor comes. You should enter the market and you should come up with the unique features in your product. See our mobile phone. Every 1 month, 2 months, we are getting new versions, new features in the phones. This is how that technology driven type of products, you should be very fast in reacting to the customer requirements and their needs. You should see that your product satisfy all those features. If you are not doing that, competitor will do and sweep the market. So you should see that the customers are the first one. So you have to maintain the customer database, what the customer feels about your product, their feedback, what else they want. If you are coming with a new product, you should update them. So data is very important, because you have to see that what the customer really wants from your product, how much your existing customer database. From this, you can calculate the market share, how many people are buying our product. So customer is very important. Cost, how I can reduce unnecessary cost. Already you all might have studied importers' value chain analysis, where unnecessarily I am adding the value, unnecessarily I am adding the cost to my various process. So what are the value added activities? What are the non-value added activities? So where unnecessary cost is going, you can find out that you can eliminate that. So you should be in quantifiable metrics like manufacturing cost, material cost, quality testing, and transportation costs. These are all very important. Are we else? Is there any other activities which is non-value added? We are wasting time in incurring the cost. Try to eliminate that. So if you are having the data, you can reduce the cost also, and you can be profitable in the business. Competition is also very important. What is this market share? What is this sales revenue? What is mine? Who are the competitors are there? What is his different products? Everything, the data is very important to study about the competitors. Complexity of the data is also important. Certain data you can process. Because of that only we are not using business analytics previous thing. The data will not be easy to condense and apply the statistical tools. SPSS itself, if you make one mistake in Excel sheet, it will show everything as wrong. You have to see that you are giving the right numbers and all. But in business analytics tools, it has a BA embedded in business analytics tools. BA means business intelligence architecture. Business intelligence is there in BA tools. In all business analytics tools, we have BA is there. It has an ETL tool. As I already told you, ETL tool will be there. It will clean the data. It will clean the data. It will process the data. E stands for extraction, T for transforming, and L for loading. And it will do the cleaning process also. It will give to the other, that is data warehouse, in a stage which is processable. So don't worry about that. Complexity means BA, business intelligence within the business analytics will helps to see that it is removing all the complexities, and it is in a form that can be easily, it is easily processable way. You can do the tools and techniques. You can take the query reporting, any queries or any problems are there. You can extract from the data and you can do anything like that. So complexity of the data is also making that it is very difficult. But business data analytics has answers to the complexity of the data also. We have criticality is there. Certain data are very important. Criticality means we all know important data we can take and we can see that. So what is very important for my business organization? What are the performance metrics? Which quantifiable metrics I should concentrate? What are the numbers? What is the data I should take it, analyze it? So that is called as criticality of your business. You don't have clarity of it. As I told you, we have a lot amount of data is there. What is the data I should take it? What is my business is about? Who is my target customers? Whether I am manufacturing products or I am a service oriented, what data will make me sense to be profitable in the business? How can I give the customer satisfaction? How can I give the maximum performance to my customers? So if you have a clarity, and if you know that by knowing the tools of the BA, you will get one clarity. These are the tools I should apply to my organization. So based on this, because of this, the data is very important. So all the C's, remember, data is very important because of the C's. In the next slide, as I already told you, analysis means it is that is called as a existing knowledge. We are doing all till now the analysis only. In analytics are very few will use it. So you can use the unknown or new knowledge is extracted by analytics. If any of the students are interested in business analytics, you can take it as a career option. I am telling you because we have lot of opportunities are there in business analytics. Nobody specialists are very less. We have a lot of opportunities are there in business analytics operators, data scientists, data analysts. So many opportunities are there. The two MBA or BPA students coupled with business analytics, you can do great wonders in this marketing world. One more thing is that. ISI, Indian Statistical Institute, Hyderabad, you all know? ISI, Indian Statistical Institute, in our Habsiguda, we have one branch is there. Yes, okay. In chat box, we are getting as, okay. ISI is there. We have ISI is there, Indian Statistical Institute, Habsiguda. They are conducting monthly training courses on BA, data analytics and business analytics for there for all the students. They are charging very nominal fee, very professionals and top experts, and they are talking on this business analytics tools. If you have any opportunity, please register. Whatever you are paying, a very less amount, I think 20 or 22, 18, something they are charging for students, very less, but whatever you are getting from that, 1 month workshop, it will be highly valuable to you. Directly will be placed as a business analytics scientist, data scientist like that. You can, I think in April, May, usually they will conduct it because those are our summer vacation for most of the students. This time because of COVID, we don't have such, but in just be looking at that website also, they'll be posting that. That will be highly useful to you. Just see here. In BA, I already told you, BA is there in already in BA, business analytics. BA refers to the set of tools and techniques that enable the company to transform data into, just you don't worry about definitions and all. BA helps in converting the data into decisional process, into a decisional process to be made available to the right persons, that is the managers, in most suitable form. In most suitable form means, I want to read it with bar chart. I want to read it in a graphical way. No, you give me two columns, extract it. How is my employee productivity? What is the output they are doing? How many working hours they are doing? What is the productivity is there? Employee productivity. It will extract those two columns, it will give you. So whatever the manager want, whichever form, whether it is a graphical form, whether you want any graphical form, pie chart, bar chart, anything you want, it will give you in that suitable form. So as I already told you, it can be qualitative information and quantitative information also. Qualitative data also we are calling it as a attitude scale, and you are converting into a what is called as a Likert scale. Qualitative also you are converting into quantitative. In all the projects you will be collecting the qualitative data only. Whether are you satisfied with my product, most likely, whatever may be the attitudes, you are measuring in the form of numbers and you are trying to analyze. Attitudes are very difficult to measure, qualitative terms. So you are converting into the attitude scale, that is Likert scale, and you are measuring that. Just see here, this is what is I'm telling you about BA architecture. It will take all type of data, internal data, external data. In business intelligence software, you are having 1, 2, 3 stages are there. That is called as a data staging. Are you seeing the second one? Actually, that is the first stage. What is the input you are taking? Internal data. Internal data will be in a structured format. Internal data will be in structured format. External data, we don't know whether it is unstructured format or semi-structured format. Then operational data, that will be in also semi-structured format. So what is structured data, unstructured data, semi-structured data, I'll explain you. Any type of data you give as an input to the data staging, that is the first stage, you are having the ETL tool, that is called as extract. You are extracting from wherever you are getting, you are transforming them into a form which is suitable to be uploaded in data warehouse. That is the next stage. You are loading it into the data warehouse. What is happening is cleansing is happening in the data. That means if I tell it as an age, you tell me what is the minimum and maximum age for a human being. Students, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, the age will be maximum. Is it 100? More than 100? We are all mortals, right?
Yeah.
We are going to die one day. So the age is now, the age is 90 or 100. Let us say 100 is the thing. That too, 18 years will be maximum. The customers will be of 18 years. Let us say for it. Because now the small students also, they are going and buying. Okay, we'll keep it as 1, 2 like that. So if you keep 0 to 100 as an age, by mistake, by typing error, I have posted instead of 70, 700. So age 700, if I process it in my any statistical software package in R language or Python programming, it will do and tell me the answer. But is it correct? It is not correct, right? 700 is not right. This is a typing mistake done by me. So here it will do the cleaning of the data. Cleaning of the data means we have to give the minimum value, we have to give the maximum. Minimum is 0 for age, maximum is 100. So if anything more than that, it won't take that data. And anything missing numbers is there, it will take 0 as the data. Any null characters or anything other characters are there, missing characters, it will take it as a 0. That is what is called as a cleansing. Cleansing means it will go and verify each cell. Whatever you have given as an input in data staging, it will see whether everything you have given is in the correct form or not. It will do all cleaning process. Then it will load into a data warehouse. In data warehouse, is a stage wherein you can apply all the tools. You can apply all the tools and you can arrive at the final things, like you can see here. Analysis, you can see. Query reporting, data mining, you can do simple statistical analysis. Queries, any queries are there, any problems are there with marketing managers or with any functional managers. You can report the problem, you can extract the data and you can give it in a very suitable form. You can data mining, you can do the data mining. Don't worry students, these are all new terms, are the same as mining. Mining means what? Mining people will dig deep into the soil, right? Here data mining means same. We are going deep and deeper into the data to mine what is the, we are extracting the relevant information about the data. So data warehouse consists of data marts. So here cleaning will take place. Don't worry about this. Data staging, data warehouse, and this is called as a data presentation. Three stages will be there. In all BA tools, all these three will be there. Right? Just coming to the next one in business analytics. Business analytics is a head of business intelligence. So as I already told you, it will give you the hidden information. What is the difference between BA and BA? That also I'll tell you. Before that, see what is business analytics. It is a structured and scientific approach to analyze the large business data to identify hidden and unknown opportunities. Hidden variable is called as analytics. We don't know that, but the system will tell you. This is where I have introduced a new product. I am not successful in market. I am breaking my head to see why it is like that. I am nowhere. It is very new product having so many features. Why my product is not successful in the market? You don't know. But if you apply analytic tools, it will take the data from competitors' data. It will take the social media data. It will take all other data, whatever we are calling it as a big data. And it will tell you this is where the competitor is doing well. He is offering the same features at the least cost, but you are not doing so. So it will tell you where we are lagging. That hidden unknown variable, I don't know, but business analytics tools will give me that insights into the data to achieve business excellence. Analytics is used on business data to take efficiently business decisions for profitability, more profits, market growth. You can explore the new markets, new products and services. You can increase the market share. What is market share? Students, what is market share?
Yes, how many customers are consuming our
product. Very good, very good. Nice. Market share means number of customers buying my product. Now this is now 40% people are customers are buying my product. Remaining 60% are competitors. How can I increase that percentage? Can I increase my 40 to 60, 70 like that? Can I increase the market share and how to maximize the customer satisfaction? Now profitability, revenues have gone, all those days have gone. Customer satisfaction, give more whatever the customer is expecting, give more with your performance, right? Trying to identify his problems, try to provide him a new product or services that solve his problems. Try to identify a problem worth solving by him. So what you are doing is that you are trying to create a customer satisfaction. Your product is speaking more than what is expected. He has expected little, but your product is doing more than that. That is called as delight. Customer satisfaction. Next step is customer delight. So business analytics tool is helping you to achieve that. Right? So it is the use of the data, information technology, analysis and quantitative methods. As I told you, simple whatever you are using as a inferential statistical tools or descriptive statistical tools. Students, you all know about inferential statistics, I hope, right? That means sampling statistics, right? So all those inferential statistical tools and what descriptive statistical tools. So statistics itself is divided into descriptive statistics and inferential statistics. Descriptive statistics means limited number of data. You want to tell how the data is there. So that type of descriptive statistics also you have studied. I hope you all have studied sampling statistics a little bit, right? That is enough. So you are taking a small sample which represents the population and you are inferring about this is what the population is. So you can use whatever your hypothesis testing also using BA. Simple tools also you can use. You can use quantitative methods. You can use what tools also. Students, have you studied operation research tools?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Can you tell me some models? Students, can you tell me some models in operations research? Anybody have gone through that subject, operations research or quantitative analysis for business decisions? Have you gone through that? No, no. Okay. Till now you don't have that. Okay, don't worry. We have linear programming problems, assignment problems are there. We have transportation problems are there, queuing problems, all those things also.
Zero sum game.
Yes, very good. Gaming theory is a queuing models, gaming theory is a, all this is also we have. Very good. We have programming languages there. How it will do the statistics, all regression analysis, time series analysis like that. All the statistical tools are embedded in BA software tools. Similarly, we have what tools also there. LPP is there. Linear programming problems, models are there. So it is a mathematical and computer-based models are also there in BA. It helps the manager to improve the insights about the business operations to make better fact-based decisions. In the next slide, we'll study about business analytics is used everywhere. It is used in pricing decisions. It is used in all the domains we use the business analytics. Where we are lagging, where we have to improve, what is the key process I should focus on, where I should bring improvement. If I know that, apply the BA tools to it. Try to gather the data, what is available, big data there. Try to gather whatever the data, apply the BA tools there. Just see the importance of BA. There is a strong relationship of BA with profits of the business, revenue, shareholders return. If you know that where we are lagging, definitely there is a scope for improvement. So BA enhances the understanding of the data. BA is vital for the business to remain competitive. It enables, it is one of the competitive advantage. Nobody, no competitor are using BA tools. If you are using it, it offers you competitive advantage. It helps you in taking the right decisions. I'll show you some example how the certain businesses are market leaders. Now they are number one in the market. What is the trick they did? How they have turned everything into every happened because of the BA tools. BA enables for the creation of information reports, all these things it will do. Just see here, this is what evolution of BA. Time study by Taylor. I think you all might have studied in the beginning management sciences, right? Time study means work measurement. Work measurement is divided into time study and method study.
Method study.
Yes. Have you studied that? Very good. What is time study? What is the time study and method study? You all have forgotten, right? Because of COVID-19, lot of gap is there, right? Am I right? So the tailor is
called time study, and using all the methods that are available is called method study.
Yes. Who is the father of scientific management? Is it F.W. Taylor? In 18th century itself, he came up with what is called as a scientific management theory. He told us how we can, what are the standard ways to measure the time, what are the standard ways of doing the work, all those things he has studied, how to increase the productivity. He has emphasized it on specialization of labors, all those things we have studied in 18th century during when industrial revolution took place in the mid of 18th century. Then OR came into picture during the Second World War. Operations research, just now I told you, right? Optimization technique. OR in one word means what? Optimization technique. I want to maximize my profits. Is it possible? I want to get 100 marks in MBA. Is it possible? Please, any one of the students respond to me.
No, ma'am.
No. The maximum marks in your college, if I ask your madam will tell you 85% is the highest mark, madam, in the previous year. Because that is what reachable. That is what reachable, even though the number 100 is there. So maximize my profitability. I cannot convert everything into profits, right? Something is there. This is called as optimization technique. Maximize profitability, maximize productivity, minimize the cost, minimize the time. But what is there? I cannot achieve 100% or something. Why? Resources are my constraint. One is money constraint. One is called as what is called as manpower constraint, one more is called as material. These are all constraints. I don't have unlimited money, is there? Resources are my constraint. This is pulling me away. Why I am not getting 90% marks? If my mother asked me, because of my friends, so many friends are there, because of that I am able to get 70%. Mommy, I will tell you. What is the reason behind that? Because I have several disturbances are there. So we could have converted that into a positive ones, right? You would have converted that into group study like that. You would have increased that. Optimization technique is what OR tells you, right? We will study the evolution of BA. Evolution of BA. So, after OR, we have one more thing is called
Mama.
Evolution. Sorry, Mama. Of BA. Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Can you tell me the correct slide, ma'am?
Evolution of BA, ma'am. Before, ma'am. Before.
I'm not finding it, ma'am.
Okay. BA architecture. Just come down, ma'am. Yeah. Yes. Okay. This is what is called as evolution of BA. That is what is called as
this one, ma'am. Is this the correct slide?
The previous one, ma'am. Previously, we are discussing that actually.
This one?
No, ma'am. Before. Okay, no problem, ma'am. Let it be. No problem, ma'am.
Yeah.
What is that we are telling is that BA came then after OR and all. We have management science. Management science and OR coupled with information technology and decision support system. If you have seen that, when I'm studying MBA in 2000 like that, we have studied decision support system, management information system. Now the subjects have changed and we are getting the business analytics. From 2-3 years, our curriculum is updated to business analytics. So decision support system, management information system, MIS is not that much, it don't take that type of, it will rely only on corporate databases. It will do the information processing with whatever the data is available. Justice will integrate the data. Whereas decision support system, it will combine all the tools and technologies. It has a BA processing inside in the decision support system. So it has a decision support system to help the managers in taking the right decisions. It is relying on the corporate databases. Then we are having a business intelligence. Then we are having a personalized computer software. So this is what is it. Just see here, this is what the classification of BA. We are having descriptive analytics, predictive analytics, and prescriptive analytics. Descriptive analytics is what BA and relying. Previously, we are having only Madam, just the current is switched off. I'll check my this thing, ma'am. Wait a minute, ma'am.
Okay,
just
ma'am.
One minute, ma'am. One minute. We have no power here.
Okay.
Wait, ma'am. Just a minute.
Yes.
So previously we are relying only on BA and BA difference. What is BA? BA is relying only on descriptive analytics. But what is BA will do? BA is depending on predictive analytics and prescriptive analytics. Just now I told you statistics itself is divided into descriptive analytics. Descriptive means how the present situation was. All the students listen here. Whenever I go to a fresh class, new class, when I came to AMSAE, there were 60 students are there in front of me, and I have to see how the students are. Whether are they slow learners, are they the slow learners are there, are they fast learners are there, how is the student's pulse I want to find out. I will see that I will conduct a small exam for 10 marks statistical exam, and I will study the pulse of the students. Yes, they are very intelligent. AMSAE students are very intelligent, so I should give them challenging assignments. I should give the challenging problems. Descriptive means what is the present situation. Are my students are very intelligent, or they are learning slowly, what is it? So descriptive means uses data to understand what is the present and past situation, how the data is there. What predictive analytics will do? Predictive means what? Prediction. You are making a prediction in future. Prediction means what is that I want to go? What is it I want to go? What is it I want to do after 2 years, 3 years? Prediction, you are making it. What my child wanted to become in near future, you are making a prediction. Students, can you tell me some predictive techniques in statistics? Predictive or you can forecasting techniques, something like that. Can you tell me whatever which comes in your mind? Students, are you able to listen? Is it audible to all of you?
Regression analysis.
Yes, ma'am. Please go ahead.
Very good. Regression analysis. Anything else? Regression analysis is a very best technique. Trend analysis, have you studied?
Trend yes,
analysis,
ma'am.
Analysis.
Yes,
we have freehand curve fitting method, semi-averages method, and moving average. Very good.
Yes.
If you draw the curve, you can forecast how it is going to happen in the future. So these are all this. Predictive analytics will tell you. It analyzes the past performance. It will predict the future probabilities and trends. It will explore the relationships which may not be visible directly by the DA. Now, BA is only restricted to descriptive, but why we are going for BA, not BA? BA will tell me about prediction. Tomorrow, where I will stand in my business, that is what prediction is. Prescriptive means what? Prescriptive means I want to be like this. I want to be first in my class. What I should do? You have to do night study. You should make your students come and they all sit together. I have to do these. If I follow these strategies, what are the assignments given my teacher, if I do, I'll get good marks. Mother, I promise you, I'll get good marks this time. How? I have to make strategies. But this is prescriptive. Prescriptive means I want to be like that. I want to double my sales in the next year. After 2 years, I want to double my sales. Is it possible? Yes. This is what BA is. BAU is play. You can place yourself somewhere and you can aim and you can dream about it, and BA tools will help you to achieve that. Is it not? Now BA is making you a distinct. This is why the BA is making you a very important study, right? Prescriptive analytics means you are going and doctor is giving you prescription, right? What is doctor is giving you? Doctor, I am having fever, cold, If I tell today fever, everybody is scared of COVID-19. See, small throat also we are fearing that we will get COVID, right? So if I tell doctor I'm a fever, normally doctor will give you follow all these medicines. After 2 days you will become all right. I'm planning for my third day. I should become all right. My health should become well. My health should become well. That is my third day I want to do it. Today doctor is giving me the prescription. That is called as prescriptive analytics. You are using optimization techniques. Prescription means you can see that in future I want to achieve it. Prescription analytics will help you in achieving that. Next slide, ma'am. Diagnostic analysis is there. What is diagnostic analytics? Diagnostic analytics means why it has happened like that. See that today we are facing the COVID-19 pandemic situation. How our economy has went down. Something has happened. What is the reason? Everything. Why is it happening like that? What is the reason? Means no economy is there. Nobody are buying. The income of the people have gone down. So many people have lost their jobs. So we don't have tourism sector. It's no more. Transportation sector, a big blow on the transportation sector. All the remaining logistics, warehousing, all are a big, what we call as a, there is a lot of backlog is there in every operations we do. So this is what diagnostic analytics is do. Why it is happened? How it is happened? What is the shocks? BSE stock exchange market went down. Because what reason it has went down? What is the reason it will analyze and it will give you the information. We have already studied about descriptive analytics. It is already there in business intelligence. In the next slide, we are going to study the predictive analytics and prescriptive analytics. As I already know, you predictive means what? Predictive analytics, what actions it will giving you the alerts, what will happen, what could happen, simulation, what will happen if the trend continues, what will happen next, prediction modeling, what will happen the next, it will tell you that. Prescriptive analytics, how we can achieve the best outcome. I want to double my sales. I want to achieve this many sales. How can I do that? So this is with these resources, you do like this, then you can do it. Optimization technique. I told you what is optimization technique. How can we achieve the best outcomes with respect to effects of variability? Stochastic optimization. Same, our war models only. Optimization technique with respect to random variables will be there. Random, the variables will go on changing. The random variables will be there. This is all these things you do have an answer here, right? So BA is having two pluses. BA is having only one. BA is having in business intelligence. Previously, decision support system also is having BA. Only descriptive analytics, but this is having descriptive, predictive, and prescriptive analytics. Next slide, ma'am. So we should know OLTP and AP is there. OLTP means online transaction processing. I'll just tell you one example with that you will understand what is OLAP, online analytical processing. The name itself you can tell that in OL, online analytical processing, analytics, what is there? So what type of system software will be used in BA tools? Definitely OLAP. Do you agree with me? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, OLAP means analytical processing. OLTP means transaction processing. Just for example, I'll give you one example. All these things you'll understand. We can skip all the slides. If you are having a savings bank account in any bank, and if any amount is debited or credited, and you have updated your phone number or if you are given that information while opening your bank account, are you getting the messages, this much amount is debited, this much amount is credited like that? Are you getting that messages, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, or else your parents also, right? So you'll be getting that message. That is called as OLTP, transactional processing. Suppose if I am having 20,000 rupees in my savings bank account, 10,000 rupees I am debiting. So I'm getting a message that you have debited 10,000 rupees. The remaining balance is only 10,000 rupees. So you are getting, what is happening to the previous message that is deleted? the previous message is deleted, whatever the new messages is updating here, that is called as updation is taking place in online transaction and processing. If you are going to a supermarket, suppose if you make a purchase, will you ask your phone number? Yes, students, will you ask your phone number when you come to the bill counter? That cashier, yes, that person will ask you, just tell your phone number. What is happening there? Transaction is happening. You are purchasing the goods, for example, say 500 rupees or 600 rupees. He'll ask you the phone number. Previously, you can get, you came in the previous month. Whatever you have purchased, that data is erased. And whatever today you have did it, that it will tell you. Okay, 600 rupees, the bill is generated. Just make the payment and you can leave. So he'll tell you that. So online transaction, wherever the transactions are happening, in airlines, supermarkets, banking, insurance, they'll use the online trans. What has happened to the previous data? That is gone. What is recently, we have to maintain inventory also, inventory manager also. What are the various products that should come? I'll maintain only that data. So whatever the transactions, day-to-day transactions will be maintained in OLTP. But the greatest disadvantage is that you cannot make the decisions there. But what actually happens in a bank is that whether you have a bank account in private, public, or whatever bank, foreign banks, what they will do is that whenever the customer is creating, or whenever he is want to create a new bank account, a unique customer ID is created. A database will be maintained for him. Starting from the day you have started the account, or you have created the savings bank account, the time starts there, right? 1-1-2020. I am starting a new bank account. I have initiated new banking account that is with the 1,000-1,500. They have made it as a minimum pay, for example. So you are having 1,500. From that day, what are the various transactions you are making, whether you are debiting or you are crediting, it will go on maintain the data in the database. So for every customer with unique customer ID, it will maintain a database, and along with the date, whatever the amount is getting credited or debited, everything it will maintain. Everything it will maintain in the database, right? So this is helpful in decision making. Suppose, for example, usually students, are you listening? So this is what is various advantages of OLTP. OLTP efficiency is a very simple, fast, we can come at the decisions. OLAP means analytical processes. It is also one of the system software. Suppose students, I am per month, every month I will debit an amount 20 to 25,000 for my monthly expenditure, for example. Suddenly if I am making more than 25,000, 60, 70 like that, it will give me alert messages like that. That is called as what is called as something abnormality is happening. Usually I withdraw the amount only the bank branches nearby. Something my amount got debited in, for example, in a Delhi branch, means in North India from Delhi branch, with my account number, my debit card, certain amount is debited. That is, we call in statistics as an outlier. Something abnormality is happening, something which is staying outside. So this type, it will help in giving us alerts and messages. This is what is called as a diagnostic analytics. So something abnormality is happening, outlier is there, you will use only within this radius, right? If you are something abnormal features are happening, it will help the bank managers to give the messages. Yes ma'am, we're going to go to the next slide. Ma'am, please go to the next slide. Have you understood that? Updation is where what is taking place in OLTP. Ma'am, please go to the next slide. Next slide. In OLAP, what is happening? Extraction and viewing is happening. Everything, whatever you draw, or if you invest the money in your bank, everything will be there. You're depositing the money or withdrawing the amount. All these things, everything will be maintained. Next slide, ma'am. Yeah. So this is called as a OLTP is multidimensional transactional process, multidimensional model. So this is example. You just go through. These are there. If I want to do anything new like that, whether I can do accessories in men's category, you can go for the OL AP. What if analysis like that you can do in only OL AP. In analytical processing is a system software, there you can do what if analysis. Go to the next slide, ma'am. So OL AP can process this. Just see here why, how, what will be the future sales of accessories. It can use what if analysis, what will happen. What if means simulation like that. What will happen if I do that? So OL AP, you can do that. With these training patterns, with this data within your hand, you can do the wonders there, right? Just go to the next slide, ma'am. I think you all have understood transactional processing and OLAP processing. BA uses analytical processing, whereas day-to-day transactions are used by OLTP. Just go to the next slide, ma'am. So this is what it will do. Fast interacted, it helps in decision making. All these things is possible only with OLAP. That means BA tools consist of online analytical processing, analytical processing system software in a. Ma'am, next slide. Now, I already told you in BA, if you just see, the output of BA is data mining. Data mining is just how that mining we'll do in the soil. We'll go deep and see that any gold or silver or any precious metals, other necessary materials are there inside the soil or Mother Earth. Similarly, we can go deep into the data and we can get the relevant information that will help in making the decision making. You can mine out, you can extract, and you can dive deep into the data, and you can take the relevant information from the large volumes of the data. Next slide, ma'am. Data mining is divided into three. Next slide. Classification, clustering, and association. Today we are going to study this thing. Go to the classification. Next slide, ma'am. Next slide. Classification. Just next. Classification. In classification is, ma'am, next slide. Classification is based on supervised learning, and clustering is based on unsupervised learning. Next, ma'am. So that means classification is supervised, means target class is known. Don't worry about all those things since supervised, unsupervised. Just see that if the population is known very well. For example, if I go and ask Kalyani madam that what is MBA first year, what is the strength of MBA first year students, and what is the strength of MBA second year students, they'll tell that this is the strength, madam. MBA first year is this much and MBA second year is this much. So that is called as a supervised learning. That is, target class is known well. Clustering means you don't know that the data is coming. Who will come as a first year students means we don't know, right? That is, they have to clear the eyesight. Still, we have COVID situation. When the admission will take place? What? Who are your MBA first year students? 2020, madam, March. This academic session means madam will have doubt because the members will be go on adding unless if I put a limit to it. So this is called as unsupervised learning. The target class is not known. For example, I have introduced a new product in the marketplace. So who are my customer? I don't know whether they like my product and the number will become 1,000, 2,000, 20,000, or nobody will buy my product. I don't know that class. That is called as a unsupervised learning. That is, the population is not known. Target class means don't worry about new term. What you have studied in statistics, population. Population is known well, population is not known well. Next slide. The classification consists of so many tools are there. It helps in detection of fraud. I told you, loan approval, pattern recognition, and image recognition. Next slide. We have so many other things like decision tree, K, nearest neighbor case, all these things are there. We'll study about in 1 minute decision tree. In decision tree, next slide. Just see here, this is what the decision tree is. Have you ever studied the decision tree? Students, decision tree in statistics?
No, okay.
Decision tree means I have so many alternatives are there. Which alternative I should choose? Suppose if I choose alternative one,
the probability is 0.7 and the profitability, that means the payoff, whatever the payoff I will get is this much amount. And if I choose the decision 2, the probability is 0.3. For the alternative 1, the probability will be 0.7 and 0.3. What is the payoff? How much amount I will be profitable? If you go on make the decisions, we are having expected monetary value is there. If I take the decision 1 and if you go through the various notes, intermediate notes, and finally you reach the leaf note, that is what we call it as a last note. What is the expected monetary value you are having? What is the expected monetary value you are having? Usually, which EMV, expected monetary value is high, that is the best alternative we will tell. Same way we are having decision 3 here. The main criteria, the main thing for in business analytics is to divide into groups. I'll divide the population into groups. See, so when osteoporosis is there, I can give you an example as a COVID here. COVID, they are telling that you take it as age below 15, age above 70, they are more vulnerable to the COVID. That is the reason my father is not allowing my in-laws to go outside to visit the temple also. They are, my father-in-law and mother-in-law, they are staying inside the house for the last 4 months. So why is it they are the immunity power will be less and they are most affected by this? So if I make the age as a criteria for COVID, is it making a sense? Yes, that is called as a decision tree analysis, right? We have a Gini index, so many things are there to tell that. I'll divide into groups. Classification. Classification means what? You are classifying the groups and you are telling that which is more this thing. I'm making these two groups. So this factor, age is relevant for COVID. COVID virus is getting affected by age is playing a prominent role. You can find out that. I have studied COVID-19 in one of my research papers as a developed and non-developed countries. It told that there is no difference for developing and non-developed countries. Even Modi can get COVID, Amitabh Bachchan can get COVID, even rickshaw man can also get COVID. It doesn't know the high status, low status, whether it is a developed country or non-developing country. It doesn't have any this thing, right? So it told me that developing and non-developing sense doesn't make any sense for COVID-19 virus. Similarly, if I take it as a vegetarian, non-vegetarian, in one of the research in England, they told that for vegetarian, the chances of coming COVID-19 is very, very less. They have proved it. So is it making any sense? This is what is called as a classification. Just see here, you are going like this, what we call as a root node and a leaf node and what is called as a intermediary node like that. And we are go on arriving like that. Inverted tree diagram until we get the answers, we will go on going like this. Next slide, we'll go to the KNN. K means nothing. You, all students, you just see that, don't think that this is something else, this is out of our boundary. Everything, whatever we have studied, that only they have put it and they have called it as a business analytics. Don't think that this is a very difficult subject, this is out of our scope, something Greek or Latin we are studying, nothing like that. Whatever we have studied, they are using the same techniques. K. Have you studied the Euclidean distance in 9th and 10th class? Do you remember, students? The distance between any two points in 9th class, 10th class, that was very important question, right? What is the distance between two points? You will write it as a distance is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2. Same thing they have used. So something not irrelevant, or if you just see everything, whatever you studied, same thing is there. If you know the right tools, you apply, take the software packages. We have Python programming. If you don't know the programming languages, people who are excelling doing the program, we have to tell them. As a managers, we have to take the right decisions. We have to tell what tools we should apply. They will do everything and they will give you the answers to you and you can take the right decisions. K, nearest neighbor, means find out the distance between two things. What is called as a sample and what is called as an unknown sample. Suppose one person, if in a police station they have found it as, or in CBI, they have named it as a terrorist person. Similar person, one of the police, in the police office or in one of the police, what we call as a police branch office at a certain place and in police station, one person, they have seen him with similar features. what they'll do is this terrorist face and this person face, they can keep it and they can see that whether the distance between these two spaces, first is terrorist space, one more is called as a that new person whom we doubt him that he will be a terrorist person, you can match it. That is what is called as a test sample and unknown sample, and you can apply the K nearest neighbor. If the distance is zero, you can tell that both are same, he is a terrorist. If the distance is more, you can tell that two are nothing. Like in detecting the cancer cells and healthy grown regular cells, how the cancer cells will be there, the doctors will be using the K nearest neighbor. How the healthy cells will be there, if you take any stomach cancer or liver cancer, anything, how the healthy liver will be there, how the cell structure will be there, how the unhealthy or cancer cells growth will be there in that particular human being. So it will most widely used in the medical field. Next field, next term. So it is used in text categorization, medical field, as I told you, for detecting the cancer. Next, graphology. If you have signed it, somebody has signed it, you can compare those two pictures. One slide will be your signature. Our signature will only vary 3-4 times. They'll take average of all the distances, the size and all, and anybody has done it, that they'll compare it. Human genome, characterizer protons, and one more is called as a case-based reasoning. Some new case will be there, old case, you'll compare it, and you will see that what are the solutions of this, and you'll make everything. Just go to the next slide, ma'am. To be very clear, you will find out the parameters in the cases. That means whatever the cases you have, I think you all might have studied so many case study analysis, right? So many business cases we have studied. Am I right, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. There you identify some parameters. Suppose, for example, problem, high fever, age is 40, infection, gender, these are all there. So if a new case is coming, that whatever the important parameters you have listed, it will compare by using the thick lines. If it matches, then it will diagnose it as a you are having a throat infection. Next slide, ma'am. Today, if you are having a sore throat, high fever, and if you are having a gastroenteritis problem, and they'll detect it as a cancer. So 4-5 parameters are there. It is used in the area of medical field. It is also used in incident report system. It is also used in question and answer system. I think most of you will be using Quora, question and answer system. So whenever you type, what is the difference between BA and BA, it will go and tell you in Quora. It is identifying that, and it will dump you in that case. So many cases are stored in the database. Whatever the parameters are matching with that, it will take that case and it will give you the answer. So it is supporting the strategic decision in small and medium enterprises. For help desk, every time we need not disturb the others. Automatic help desk, what is the frequent problems we are getting, we can do a automatic help desk. This is called as a clustering. This is very helpful in market research. It is an unsupervised learning. We don't know what type of items are adding to our population. It helps to group the objects in clusters. It is also used in image processing, pattern recognition. These are all the things there. So clustering is also used in marketing research. We will try to group them. Association is there. Association helps. It is also widely used in marketing management. It is used in market basket analysis, wherein it will tell you that it helps to when the two products, co-occurrence of two items. So you have to sell only one product, or you have to sell along with it more than two products. Suppose if I'm selling my mobile phones, I have to sell the accessories also, earphones also. What is it? It helps in the arrangement of stores also. It has helps in combo plans, everything it will tell you. So these are all certain terms are there in association. When a customer is buying a bread, what are the chances that he'll buy the butter also? Just see the support. Support means when a person is buying a mobile phone, what are the chances that he'll buy the earphones also? Other accessories also. What are the accessories? So it will tell you that what is the fraction, probability. You can tell it as a support means P of X intersection Y. Confidence means P of conditional probability. y by x, all these things are used in the association techniques. So this is called as big data. As I already told, it is available in different formats. Volume is there, large volume of data, quickly it is coming, variety of data is coming, veracity is also, uncertainty of data is also there. So I already told you, structured data, unstructured data, and semi-structured data, three types of data. Structured data means everything will be there, clearly specified. Unstructured data means you don't know the data elements. Semi-structured means you know the data elements, but it will be very difficult to combine it. Suppose if I ask you, in one database, it will be only name. In another database too, I'll have first name and second name. How to combine these two, so you'll be having a problem. So these are the primary sources of big data. Yes, ma'am. What is the next slide? Internal sources of data, external sources of data. So these are all the various models, least square models, multiple regression. These are all we have studied a little bit. I think we have studied now classification, supervised learning. We have studied decision tree, k nearest neighbor, case-based analysis, all these things. Artificial neural network is also there. That also regression trees, all these things will come. Machine learning models, naive Bayes method, that is based on Bayes probability, conditional probability. We have neural networks are there. We have artificial neural networks are there. If time permits, I'll explain you that. Next slide, ma'am. So this is, what is your problem type and what are the applicable techniques? Just see here, hypothesis testing. It will do this classification. Just now I told you the target class or population is known very well. Value estimation means these are all the various methods it will use. So these are the so many data techniques it will use, right? So with this, I think almost you will get an idea about it. It helps us if you want to see you where you can place yourself and what are the strategies you have to adopt. How to use your resources effectively. This type of for this type of answers, we are having a solution in solution in business analytics. Just see here, we have behavioral analytics is there. McDonald's, they are having a tracking the vast amount of data to see that to improve the operations. Just see there, they are using the data here. If the customer comes and he will place an order through drive-through experience, he is going through his car in drive-through, he will get the orders and he will receive everything, whatever he has placed it. The madam will share you all the slides to you. This is where they are used as a customer segmentation, predictive analytics, market basket analysis. I told you when they purchase two items together, fraud detection, Jion's Bank, and what we called as a John Deere company is the last, was the last company, farming equipment, that is also there. In Jion Banks also they are using the data analytics to determine, as I told you about the bank, any abnormalities are there, outliers are there also, it will detect you. And the final one is John Deere company, it's a farming company. So in they are not only selling their manufacturing equipments, that is for farmers, farming the tractors or farming equipments to the farmers, but they have a data-driven technology inside it. They have a sensors attached to the soil and as well as the sensors attached to the machines also. That is internal data. It will take the external data, like what is the commodity prices and what is how the weather temperature is, how what is the suitable soil, how the soil is, how is the weather conditions. It will take about the various seeds. It will cut these internal and external data and it helps the farmers to take the right decision. They have a cloud computing system is there. So whoever the farmers who are buying the farming equipment from the John Deere company, they have access to my johndeere.com portal, the farmers can go through, and they can see that real time systems through apps, they can interact with them, which seeds will be suitable for them to increase the productivity, to reduce the downtime. All these type of decisions can are taken place, and John Deere equipment, that is farming equipment, was very, very successful. Right, with this I wind my topic. Right, thank you very much. I thank to the director of AMSAI for giving me this wonderful opportunity to share whatever the little knowledge I am having to the students and faculties and others. Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you, Kalyani ma'am, for giving me so much patience. You are answering my questions, and you have taken this good initiation to see that all your students are get equipped with modern trends with management. My students or our students should not go out of whatever the recent trends is there. That was your idea. I really appreciate that, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. Students, do you have any questions for ma'am? Yes, participants, do you have any questions for ma'am?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. Okay. Kindly. Hello. Kindly mute yourself. Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. They can post in chat box also, ma'am. They are having any questions.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, girls. If you have any questions, please post it in the chat box. Ma'am, they have liked your. Lecture.
Yes,
they
thank
would,
you.
They would. They would, it's very informative and good session, and they would. They want the PPT, madam.
Definitely.
They want me to share the PPT. They want you to get the PPT.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
Please,
yes, ma'am.
Please share it to the active participants, madam.
Yes, ma'am. Sure. Director, ma'am. Yeah. Meanwhile, the feedback. The feedback form is posted in the chat box. All the participants, please kindly fill up the feedback form. You will be getting the certificate shortly. Ma'am, shall I propose the vote of thanks?
Yeah, please propose the vote of thanks.
Yes. Yeah. It's my privilege to propose the vote of thanks on behalf of the management, staff, and students of AMSAI. I thank you, Dr. Yes, Lakshmi Madam, for sharing your valuable knowledge and insights about business analytics with our participants. I'm sure they must be now having an idea of what business analytics is and how powerful it can turn out to be in future. And I'm sure they'll be enthused to aim for a career in this particular field in future. I would like to thank our management, Director Ma'am, Professor K. Vijayalakshmi Ma'am, and staff for the cooperation. Technical support by Raghava sir, and in the end I would like to appreciate the interest of the participants in exploring the new facets of knowledge by attending this webinar. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you very much.
Shall I end it, ma'am?
Yeah. Thank you, Lakshmi. Really, it is very elaborative explanation by you, and easy for the students also to understand. And such a kind of simple explanation with examples. It was a wonderful session. I must thank you for your immediate acceptance. So I feel happy because still you are associated with AMSAI.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
It was pleasure in giving seminar to you.
Thank you, all the participants. So we will disperse.
Thank you, ma'am. The feedback form is in the chat box. Kindly fill up. And thank you, one and all, once again. Jai Hind.
Thank you.